Our customers, so we have a platform, so we have a website which is like which has been operational for more than 3 years now. So they can reach out to us from there. So we have a very simple form whereby they just need to fill out some details and our customer calling team gets back to them. Obviously, we all are a result of our upbringing, our personal experiences of what we have went through in life. I come from a very middle class family whereby my parents were like, I was fortunate enough to have parents who valued education much more than anything else.
Hi Ravi, this is Krishani Poddar. I'm a community manager at Startup Planes. I'm delighted that you have taken out time for this interview. So can we start with your introduction?
So this is Ravi. I am one of the co-founders and CTO of Insurance Samadhan. So we are India's first technical platform for resolution of insurance complaint. So very shortly, I will describe. We do not sell any kind of an insurance, but what we do is if somebody has been missold or there is a claim rejection that you guys are facing. So if anybody, any aggrieved policy holder is a victim of misselling of insurance or a claim rejection across any life, health or general. So we deal in those cases. We help them represent their complaints. So that is what we do.
Okay. So what does Insurance Samadhan do? Can you tell us about your audiences?
Every aggrieved policy holder is our audience. So we, as I mentioned earlier also, we are India's first technical platform for resolution of insurance complaints. So for example, I will give you, there are elderly couples who are sold insurance in lieu of an FD. So some people are sold in lieu of loans, they are sold insurance policies. What happens, the cascading effect of all this is, when you apply for a claim or when you file for a claim, your claim gets rejected. What we have figured out is, that the problem with this is the communication gap. So the insurance policy holder, the aggrieved policy holder, is not able to articulate the complaint well. So the culprit in all this is the miscommunication that happens between the insurance policy issuer and the insurance policy holder. So what we are doing at Insurance Samadhan is we are putting technology as a solution provider, as an enabler to solve this problem, mammoth problem that India is facing right now.
Okay, that's great. So what was the most difficult part in the early stage of your company's growth?
I would not say the difficult part, but there were some challenges. So one of the challenges was that how would the insurance companies entertain the complaints which has already been rejected by them? But over at a period of time, what we realized was that the insurance companies were already looking for something like this. So what we do is, we do not take every insurance complaint that comes to our platform to the insurance company. We have our in-house tech build filtration process whereby we filter out complaints on the basis of certain parameters and genuinity. Once we do our due diligence, and it is a very thorough due diligence that we do, once we are convinced that this complaint has enough proofs, then only we take these complaints to insurance companies. What insurance companies then do is, they understand, we communicate in a manner that they want to understand, because insurance at the end of the day is a technical field. So what the insurance policy holder was trying to do was, like, he was telling a lot of emotions, putting a lot of emotions, my claim got rejected, this and that. But what we do is we filter out those emotions and we only take the facts and then represent them in a manner which the insurance company understand. So over the period of time, the insurance companies have started accepting us with open hands. So this was one of the challenges. The second challenge was that people don't know that something like this exists in our country. What happens is, like, even if you will ask in your family or in your friends or in your groups, that once a claim is rejected, either you go back to the insurance company or you go back to the person who sold you the insurance. Maybe it may be an agent, it may be a broker, it may be a bank. But after that, there is nothing that you can do. So it is like you don't know what to do right now. But now there is an option. We are like, we call ourselves as the DRS of insurance ecosystem, decision review system. So once a decision has come, so we try to review that decision. So our challenge is, like, we want to make people understand and know that there is something like this which exists and the door is not closed on them. They can still come to us and we will represent their complaint.
Okay. So what was the gap in the market that you identified?
yeah, so the gap was the communication part, because like what you were communicated at the time of selling of insurance was completely different from what was sold to you. And the cascading effect, as I mentioned earlier, was the claim will get rejected. So now this miscommunication, this is the gap that we are trying to fill, because insurance companies at the end of the day are also looking to give claims to people. It is not like that the insurance companies are like have any kind of a misintention. They are working with their best capability and best intentions, but the communication part is the problem. The policy holder, the aggrieved policy holder, doesn't know how to represent his insurance complaint. So this communication gap we identified in the market, and we are bridging this gap with technology as an enabler. So we partnered with everybody. So for example, any broker in the country, MFCs in the country, hospitals, and we have partnered with top 3000 advisors in the country who sell our services to their prospects, to their customers. So this part of miscommunication is the gap that we identified, and then, and that is what we are fulfilling.
That's great. So can you just explain your business model?
As far as our business model go, it is we take a very nominal fees from our direct customer. It is like a very nominal fees of 500 INR. Once the claim money gets in your account, so you receive the money in your account, then only we charge a success fee. So there is a percentage which we charge on the amount that you receive in your bank account. But that is only after you have received the money. So there is nothing apart from that nominal registration fees that we take.
So how can your customers reach out to you?
Our customers, so we have a platform. So we have a website, which is like, which has been operational for more than 3 years now. So they can reach out to us from there. So we have a very simple form whereby they just need to fill out some details and our customer calling team gets back to them. Then there is a WhatsApp chatbot. You can contact with sending a simple hi to our WhatsApp number. Then our WhatsApp chatbot starts the communication with you. Then there is an IVR number that we have. For example, if because most of the people in tier 4, tier 5, tier 6 cities where this problem is massive. So those people want to pick up phone and want to talk to somebody. So if I tell you that the psyche of the customer is he has already been duped or he has already faced a claim rejection. So what he now wants is to pick up his phone and talk to somebody to gain that confidence. So there is the IVR channel also that is there. Apart from this, so we have our social media handles where we are very, very active. We keep doing awareness programs and series. We do small videos. We have our insurance head and co-founder Mr. Shailesh, who is a veteran from the industry. He keeps posting 2 to 3 minutes nuggets of wisdom of what to look at an insurance, what to do when buying an insurance policy, all that. We have been covered by national media extensively in the past. We keep getting covered by national media. So that is how like people can reach us. We are all over the internet. We are all over the industry. So there are many ways, and we'll be launching many more in the coming days.
That's great. So Ravi, what is, according to you, what are the qualities that an entrepreneur should possess?
An entrepreneur should possess. Okay, so if I have to start with the qualities of an entrepreneur, the first and the foremost quality that I would say is people management. So if you are running a business, you are running a family, you are running anything, or you are want to like, so the first thing is how to understand human psyche. So once you are good with humans, rest of the thing follows. Second is like you have to be disciplined with your efforts, with your execution, because once you are at that position, then people look up to you, how you do, what you do. Every word of yours is like dissected by people who look up to you. So you have a responsibility, because you can change people's lives, because people look up to you, and the way you behave, the way you do things has an impact on people's life. So I think, yeah, if I have to just pick out one, I will say people management is the foremost quality that an entrepreneur should have. And like there are like cliche qualities that if I say you have to be a hustler, you have to keep going at it, you have to be a problem solver. But yeah, after a while, the people management is one thing that supersedes every other quality that a person should have.
Right. So has your personal life experience shaped your thought process, or was it interaction with other people that you worked on?
So it was a mix of both, Krishani. Obviously, we all are a result of our upbringing, our personal experiences of what we have went through in life. I come from a very middle class family, whereby my parents were like, I was fortunate enough to have parents who valued education much more than anything else. So they made it a point that I get good education. I have lost out on various things because I was not interested in. So I decided to do first medicine, then I decided to go in army, then there was a couple of other things that I tried. But at the end, I keep leaving all of them because I was not able to find that zone where I would like to prosper further. After that, I did a drop year also in between. Then I figured out that engineering is something, coding is something which will give me a tool whereby I can impact people's life easier way. Then obviously I have worked with some of the smartest people in this country. So I have worked in unicorns also. Right now I am also working with a CEO who is one of the smartest guy I have come across. So yeah, so what my thought process is being shaped by obviously the upbringing, my personal experiences in life, but equally important are the people that you sit with, you spend your time with. You are a product of your surroundings. So yeah, so that's it.
That's great. So can you tell us about the culture which is at Insurance Samadhan? Why should a job applicant work with you?
So at Insurance Samadhan, we have a fun and a loving learning culture. So we have an open door policy. Any CXO, any founder, you can reach out to them if you have any kind of suggestion, any problem, anything. So it's not like that you have to go through hierarchies and everything. We have an open door policy, very open culture. We have a very, very young crowd that works with us. So we have most of the team, apart from the founders, who are below 30. So there is that youth exuberance and energy that we have. These people, we are fortunate enough to have a very, very good team who want to learn and grow in their career. Yeah, so their energy rubs onto us also. And it's been fun working with them. So yeah, we have been fortunate enough to have a very, very good team and good people working with us. And we are looking for many more to join us. And it's a responsibility that we have. We have to maintain this culture going forward.
You're right. So if it wasn't for your company, what you would be doing right now?
It would not have been for Insurance Samadhan, then I would be solving another problem, doing another startup, solving another thing.
Problem
solving. Because that's what it is. Because at the end of the day, if you're not solving a problem, I don't think if you can get up in every morning and you do not have a problem or a challenge in front of you, then it's exciting. So yeah, I would be figuring out some other point, some other problem in life. I am already a startup failure founder, so I have failed in the past, but that doesn't deter me into trying new things. Yeah, so I would have been doing something else, solving another problem.
That's great. So what do you do to keep yourself updated?
So I read a lot. That is one thing. I am basically an introvert by nature. So the second best option that I have is to read as many books or as much stuff as I can. So I take experiences from my interactions with people who are smarter than I am. One thing that I constantly work on is I should hire people and I should work with people who are way smarter than me. So that is one thing that I keep doing, reading. And then I follow very, very good people on Twitter, which has shaped my thought process because they have been through this journey before me. And they have gone through that journey and then they share their experiences. You find a sense of connect with them. So Twitter has been a very, very source of finding information. Yeah, and I try to read as much as possible. So technically wise, there are blogs that are over there. I try to be hands-on with the technology. So I still code. I still exercise my skills. It's not like that I have got into a CTO position that I stop. But I am very hands-on with everything that I do. Yeah, and like as I keep repeating, working with people who are smarter than me keeps me grounded and humbled. So yeah, I keep learning from them.
That's great. So what are the recent and the long-term plans of your startup?
So our short-term plan is that we want to launch our next product, which will be an app whereby we'll be telling people what is good and bad about insurance, what to look forward in an insurance policy, and all these services that I told you about claim rejections, mis-selling and everything. We'll be making it as easy as a click of a button to contact, to connect with us, to file their complaints with us for the representation. So that is something that we want to do in the near future, and we have already started working on it. In long term, we want to expand because this problem is not pan India only, but this is a problem that is plaguing the world. So this is a bigger problem in Middle East and in the West. So we want to like, so our CEO has already started in talking with the Gulf countries. So that's our long-term plan to make something which can solve this problem which is plaguing the world. So yeah, we'll be trying to solve this going forward in many more countries than India. But yeah, India is priority, and if we do India, then we can best the difficult. So if you can solve for India, you can solve for anywhere in the world.
Right. So what are your long-term and the recent plans? Like, what are your recent plans as an individual?
As an individual, what are my my immediate plans is to take insurance Samadhan to the next level.
Long-term plan
I haven't thought of really seriously, because I take one day at a time. Let's see, because right now this is the most priority thing in my life. Apart from this, I have a kid who is 3-year-old. Maybe raising him to be a good human being and a problem solver is the long-term plan, I can say.
Okay. So are you raising external fund, or are you willing to raise external fund in your near future?
So we have raised funds in the past also. So we were funded by one of the biggest incubator in India. We were funded by them in February 2020, Venture Catalyst. We are going to close our round in a few days, second round, and the news will be out soon. So I will let you do the waiting for that. Once the news come out, then you will find out. Yeah, so we were looking to, and going forward, depending on the kind of business, we will be looking to raise depending on the what is the requirement and what is like what the future holds for us.
Okay. So lastly, what are your feedbacks on Startup Plains?
First of all, thanks for having me. It's been a pleasure interacting with you and the team. You guys have been professional. I wish all the luck for you guys. And it's been a joy to work with a group of people who are extremely smart, focused, know what they want to. And platforms like these, which gives a stage for other people to get into the mindset of other people via interviews, via these. So they are bound to grow, and I wish all the luck for you and the team going forward.
Thank you so much, Ravi. So now we have come to the end of this interview. Thank you so much for taking out time. It was great talking to you. I'm sure that the information provided by you in the course of this interview will be helping the budding entrepreneurs and the founders to pave their way to their success. We hope to connect with you in the future. Thank you so much. Take care.
Thank you, Kani. And once again, thanks for having me. It was a pleasure, and looking forward. Thank you.
Thank you.